In my previous videos, I have already discussed the functioning and the circuit diagram of synchronous ticket counter. In this video, I am going to explain the truth table of ticket counter, how we get the counting from 0 to 9 of ticket counter, as this is a ticket counter. So there are 10 states in that counter, 10 possible states. 10 possible state means it can count from 0 to 9. So for 0 to 9, we need counting 0 to 9, we need 4 flip-flop. Okay, we need 4 flip-flop, and the initial value of the 4 flip-flop is 000, and its last counting should be 9, that means 1001. So after getting this value in the 4 flip-flop, that flip-flop should return to its previous value. This is the main purpose of ticket counter. Now, as there are 4 flip-flop, Q1 here, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 are the outputs of the 4 flip-flop. So if this is the 4 flip-flop, then we get the output. First flip-flop gives Q1, this is Q2, this is Q3, this is Q4. We get this output from this flip-flop, and we all know that it gets its input from Q1, this flip-flop gets input, this flip-flop gets its input from this, and only first flip-flop gets its input from an external source. This is already discussed in our previous videos. Now I'm going to discuss about how we get the truth table. Okay, here Q1, that means the output of first flip-flop, will toggle at each clock pulse. Q2 toggles when Q1 and Q4 is 0. Q3 toggles when Q1 and Q2 equals to 1 in previous clock pulse, and Q4 toggles when Q1 and Q4 is 1 when Q1 and Q4 is 1, or Q1, Q2, Q4 is 1. Either one of this condition is satisfied, then Q4 toggles. Now let us start. Here, for the truth table, we have clock, and as this gives the Q4 gives the MSP and Q1 gives the LSP, we should write Q4 in first, then Q3, then Q2, then Q1. As I have discussed, it starts from zero counting. So for the clock 0, whenever no clock is applied, all the flip-flop value must be 0, initial value. Okay. Whenever we give its second clock pulse, then we all know that the first flip-flop always changes whenever clock is applied. So Q1 toggles at each clock pulse. So Q1 becomes 1 as its previous value is 0. Q2 toggles when Q1 is 1 and Q4 is 0. Q1 is 1 and Q4 is 0. Here Q4 is 0 but Q1 is not 1. So Q2 will not toggle, so its value is 0. Q3 toggles when Q1 and Q2 is 1 in previous clock pulse, but in previous clock pulse Q1 and Q2 0, so this will not toggle. Q4 toggles either Q1 and Q4 1, so Q1 and Q4 are not 1, or Q1, Q2, Q3 1. Here Q1, Q2, Q3 are also not 1, so this will also not changes its value. In clock 2, Q1 always toggles, so it changes 1 to 0. For Q2, Q1 is 1, so this will also toggle. For Q3, Q1 and Q2 both are not 1, so it stores its previous state. Previous is 0, now also 0. At Q4, Q1 and Q4 are not 1. Also, Q1, Q2, Q3 are not both 1. So this will also store its previous state. Now, in our third flip-flop, Q1 is toggles, so it changes from 0 to 1. Q2 will not toggle as Q1 is 0 in previous clock pulse, so it stores its previous state. Q3 will not toggle as Q1 and Q2 both are not 1, so it stores its previous state. Q4 will store its previous state as Q1, Q2, Q3 are not 1, and Q1 and Q4 are also not 1, so it will not toggle, it stores its previous state. for fourth clock pulse, Q1 toggles 120. For Q2, in previous clock pulse, that is in clock pulse 3, Q1 is 1, so it also toggles. For Q3 value, Q1 and Q2 is 1. We know that Q3 toggles when Q1 and Q2 is 1. So Q4, Q3, as Q1 and Q2 is 1 in previous clock pulse, B2 toggles. For Q4 value, Q1, Q2, Q3, both 3 are not 1, and Q1 and Q4 are also both not 1. So this will not toggles its value and store its previous value. For fifth clock pulse, first one is toggles. Q2 value will not change as Q1 is 0 in previous clock pulse. Q3 value also not change as Q1 and Q2 both are 0, not 1 in previous clock pulse. Q4 value will not change as Q1, Q2 is 0, both 3 are not 1, and also Q1 and Q4 are 0, not 1. So this will also not change to its previous value. For 6th clock pulse, Q1 value always changes, that means toggles 120. Q2 value is change, it toggles that because in 5th clock pulse, Q1 value is 1 and we are now 6th clock pulse, so this will toggles. For Q3 will not toggle and Q1 and Q2 both are not 1, so it stored its previous value. Q4 value also stored its previous value as Q1, Q2, Q3 both are 3 and not 1, and Q1 and Q4 both are not 1, so it stored its value. For 7 clock pulse, Q1 chain toggles, that means 0 changes to 1. For Q2 value, as Q1 is 0 in previous clock pulse, it will not change, store its previous value. For Q3 value, Q1 and Q2 both are not 1, so it store its previous value. For Q4 value, these 3, Q1, Q2, Q3 are not both 1, and also Q1 and Q4 are not 1, so this will not change. For 8th value, for 8th clock pulse, Q1 always changes, so it's 1, so it's now 0. For Q2 value changes as Q1 is 1 in previous clock pulse. Q3 changes as Q1 and Q2 are 1 in previous clock pulse. Q4 changes as Q1, Q2, Q3, so 1 condition is satisfied, so this will changes into 1. For 9th clock pulse, Q1 also changes to 1, because it changes to 1 now, it toggles, that means previous value is 0, now it is 1. For Q2 value will not change as Q1 is 0. Q3 value will not change as Q1 and Q2 are 0, not 1. Q4 value will not change as Q1, Q3, both 3 are 0, not 1, and Q1 and Q4 both are not 1, so this will store its value. Now you see, we have reached our last counting 9. You see here, this is the main point. So now the flip-flop again has to be gets back to its first state. That means we don't need any further counting. We need the flip-flop must be changes to its first state. So let us see in the next clock pulse, the first flip-flop doubles, that means 1 changes into 0. For Q2 value, Q2 value, you see Q1, for Q2 value there must be two condition. You see Q1 must be 1 and Q4 must be 0, okay, both are have AND condition. So here Q1 is 1 but Q4 is not 0, so this value of Q2 will not change. Okay, for Q3 value, Q1 and Q2 both must be 1, but here both are not 1, so this will not change. For 9 value, you see there are two conditions for Q4 toggles. One is either Q1 and Q4 1 or Q1, Q2, Q3 1. Here Q1, Q2, Q3 both are not 1, so one condition is failed, but you see Q1 and Q4 1, so according to the second condition, the Q4 flip flop value will be toggle. So toggles means it will changes to 0. Okay. So now you see here we get the our first flip flop initial state, that is our first state. Okay. This is how we get our truth table of decade flip-flop by using the rules of this output value.